Last time I took everything in the known universe out of this box and put it on the table. Wait, where are the black holes? These are always so hard to find. Okay, everything in the known universe, and in this video what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you how to put it together because, let's be honest, nobody reads the manual. Okay, let's start with a galaxy. You see how there are a bunch of small solar mass black holes and then this one supermassive black hole? Let's take the supermassive black hole and put it right there. That's gonna be the center of our galaxy. All right, let's put in the stars. So I'm gonna build this a little bit like our galaxy. So let's start with the red stars and fill it up with about 100 billion of those. Then we have our yellow and orange stars, and that's about 20 billion. And then we're gonna put in just sprinkle a few billion blue and white dwarfs in there. And then we're gonna take our small black holes and we'll just sprinkle them in. That's about 100 million of those. Now this is looking good. Let's tweak a few of these. And then let's spin it up. Okay, you'll notice around the edges, the stars aren't moving quite as quickly as you're used to from your everyday experience with galaxies. And actually, let me try something. So I'm just gonna see how much this sort of like, so it feels a little light. Okay, I think I know how to solve our spinning star problem and the weight. Let's put in some dark matter here. So let's just spray that. Now you'll notice that we have this spherical halo of dark matter that we sprayed in there. And let's spin it up a little bit faster so the stars don't fall in. We have our galaxy, but you'll want to put together the entire universe. Now, I'm not gonna put together the entire universe because that's an infinite number of galaxies and this is just a tutorial. I'll let you handle that. I'll just put together the entire observable universe because that's only about 2 trillion galaxies. Let's go ahead and do that. I think it's ready. The observable universe. I thought since it's about 13.8 billion years old, it would be about 13.8 billion light years across. But if we look at it, it seems like, yeah, it's about 46 billion light years across. Bigger than I thought. That's the opposite of what happened when I ordered my computer. You can tell this universe is old because it's filled with cosmic webs made of galaxies. But if we look at a younger universe, it's mostly a sea of hydrogen with a star here or there. Okay, back to our universe. Now, don't forget, you need to water it so it can grow. It can expand. And what you need for that is some dark energy. Now that's a little bit better. It's growing, expanding. If you hold on to it for say 10 billion years, it'll approximately double in size. Now that is a good investment. What do I think of the universe? Well, it's nice. It has the perfect properties for life. It's a little bit sparkly. It's sort of a ripoff because most of it's empty space. Also, it doesn't really hold up well over time. After a while, it turns into mostly holes, just black holes and almost nothing else. And even those disintegrate after long enough. So I'm gonna go ahead and give this 3 stars. Oh what? Oh no. Congratulations, you've made it to the end of the video. You have won yourself other videos, subscribe button, like button, and let me know in the comments, how many stars would you give your universe and why?